Edie, and welcome to the sixth attempt at filming the Discovering Your Energetic Wheel of the Year Beltane edition. Oh my god, dudes. I've tried to record this video six different times, and it's been one technological issue after another. I don't usually put too much stock in the whole Mercury retrograde thing, but dudes, it's made a believer out of me this time because it's been one technological glitch after another. So I sincerely apologize about this video being so late. I know that today is Beltane, but hey, at least it is up finally, I hope. I have another version of this actually recorded, and I need to let you know that I'm gonna actually watch that footage because I think there are some good tidbits in there, because I was just kind of riffing and just kind of talking, you know, out of my butt, really. I was gonna say talking off the top of my head, but the truth is I was talking out of my butt. So there are probably some good nuggets in there that will not make it onto this one, just because it was just so spur of the moment and just so fluid and organic. So I'm gonna try and edit that clip down and add some of those interesting tidbits at the end of this video. So if you see me in a different position or wearing different clothes and a lot of noise and chaos going on, that's what happened. There were just some good nuggets that I didn't want to lose. So I'm hoping that today's video is going to be just as good, because the one that I actually got recorded, there were some really good nuggets in there, but it was just so noisy and chaotic in my neighborhood that I was not comfortable sharing that terrible, terrible fucking footage with all of you. So I'm outside again today. It's actually fucking chilly. I'm so irritated with the weather right now. It is high spring. It's fucking May. And it's still cold. It's still cold outside. So I'm sitting in the shade right now, and I actually have chill bumps because it's still that chilly outside. And it's a nice sunny day, but the breeze is still really cold. So this is the Beltane edition of the Discovering Your Energetic Wheel of the Year series. Remember, this is an absolutely free series that I'm doing just for those of you here in Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place. It is my gift to you, just for saying thanks for hanging out and sharing my personal associations with all of the Sabbats and Esbats as the wheel turns through the year. Please do not share the links outside of the group here, but if you know someone that would be interested in this series or who would benefit from it, please just ask them to join the group. That way they can join in the conversation, they can see the videos, and they can participate in the discussions that happen. So again, this is just for all of you here in Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you, and I love that you spend your time with me and make space in your world for me. So thank you for that. All right, so let's talk about Beltane. I have, again, two pages of notes, and the last video that I did on the Ostara video, I tried to make it as, I tried to cut out as much of the junk as possible and just try to keep the video flowing, you know, keeping all of the topics together, but I felt like that kind of stifled me, and I really wanted to just be able to flow and just share things with you. So I have notes on the things that I want to mention, but I cannot do a script. I can't even do, you know, having my notes sitting here and just trying to read off of the bullet points and talk a little bit about them. I really just need a basic idea and then to just talk. So this video is probably going to be a lot more relaxed than the Ostara video. I mean, I was relaxed in the Ostara video, but I was trying to, I think, just trying to force it to be a little bit too professional, and fuck that, you guys know I'm so not professional. So here I sit with two pages full of notes. So if you see me looking down, that's why. I'm not gonna edit all that shit out again. It just is what it is. I'm not gonna try and pretend to make it something more professional than it really is, because it really is just me sitting here sharing my associations and the way that we celebrate all of the Sabbats and Esbats throughout the Wheel of the Year. So This is the Beltane edition. Beltane is on May 1st, also known as May Day. And Beltane is one of the larger celebrations on the Wheel of the Year. It's actually one of the biggest, traditionally. However, it's not that big of a deal for me. So traditionally, Beltane is the largest fire festival. It is highly celebrated. It is one of the big ones, you know? But for me, it's one of the smallest, actually, to be honest. I don't do the whole big Beltane celebration. It just doesn't work out like that for me. So you really need to discover what feels right for you, and in doing your journal prompts, you will come to realize whether or not it's one of your big ones or whether it's one of the lesser holidays for you. So speaking of the journal prompts that you did for the Ostara edition are going to be the exact same journal prompts that you do here for Beltane. So basically, you're just paying attention to your surrounding, what your surroundings, and that includes within yourself, within your home, within your neighborhood, within your city, just kind of your region, paying attention to the cues that are happening in that area and within yourself, and tapping into how you feel at this time of year and the energy level that you have and the things you want to do and the things you enjoy at this time of year. You're going to be tapping into all of that and discovering your personal associations for this holiday. So I'm not going to talk about the journal prompts again. I think I went over those fairly in depth for the Ostara video. I will post a file here in the group with the questions listed on it, so that way you don't always have to refer back to the Ostara video to watch the video and find the questions and listen to all that shit again. However, if you are just coming in at this point in the series, you may want to refer back to the Ostara video and just take a look at the journal prompts. You know, kind of listening to my description of them and why I ask those questions and the things you should be looking for in the answers for those prompts. I'll even try and go back to the Ostara video and find the point in the video where I start actually talking about the journal prompts and just post a little note about, you know, if you have questions about these prompts, refer to Ostara video starting at this time. That way you don't have to sit through the whole fucking video again just to see the journal prompts. So let's talk about Beltane. So, Beltane for me is normally high spring. So, oh, you little bastard. There's a fucking spider. There was a spider. God damn. I hate bugs. He's still on. Do you see him? He's on the fucking lens. I think he's too high for you to see him. Oh, you little bastard. He's gonna fucking die. He's gonna die. You're gonna die. Move. Just move a little bit more. Little bit higher, you little fucker. I'm sitting outside. And now that I've seen that spider, I'm a little bit freaked the fuck out. Oh, did I get him that time? I don't know. I don't know if I got it. I don't know. So, as you know, I'm not an outdoorsy kind of girl. But it's Beltane and it's spring, so I'm trying to do a cool looking video and sit my happy ass outside in the grass. I'm sitting on the grass. Granted, I'm sitting on a little blanket, but I'm in the grass, dude. This does not happen. I don't do this, but I'm trying to do it for you. And in the last video, you might see some little clips of that one at the end of this. There are bees, there are all kinds of issues, and I ended up back in the sunroom. That may happen again today if I see too many more bugs. You can see I'm itchy. I'm getting twitchy now. I'm itchy and twitchy because of the bug situation. So, moving along, I'm going to try and get through this video today. God, this is attempt 6. If I don't get through it today, I swear to God, I'm just going to edit the other one, the crazy one, and put it up because I can't with this video again. Okay, so, Beltane, high spring. So, at this time of year, it's May 1st. It should be spring. Like, the grass should be green and growing and needing to be cut frequently, and the trees should be in full bloom and full of big bright green leaves, and the flowers should be blooming, and there should be fucking pollen everywhere, and obviously the fucking bugs are out and the bees are pollinating and the birds are chirping. So that is high spring. In my neck of the woods in Virginia, it's still chilly and I'm sitting here with goosebumps, but in my neck of the woods, it is still a little chilly some days and I'm sitting here with fucking chill bumps, but for the most part, it is spring. Spring is in full bloom. And that's what Beltane celebrates, is that high energy, everything in full bloom, everything is coming to life, and it has, we have broken free of the clutches of winter. We can tell that it's actually really spring now. We have left winter in the dust and everyone has kind of reached out. They're stretching, they're placing their face to the sun and enjoying this nice awakening, this full bloom spring awakening. So, you can also see that the days are gradually getting longer. So if you're paying attention to that kind of thing, you'll notice that maybe not every single day is a change, but over the course of a few days or every week or so, you can definitely see the shift in the daylight hours. You can, I kind of track it by dinner time for me, because we usually eat dinner around 6 o'clock. So, you know, in the very first part of spring, like back at Ostara, it was barely light around dinner time for us. It was barely daylight. And now I'm seeing that it is still nice and bright outside when we're having dinner. And maybe even after dinner, there's still some light in the sky. So you will see that shift to the longer days, because during the summer, that's when we have the longest days. And we are gradually making our progression towards those longer days. And you can kind of track it by dinner time if you're like me. So, we have finally left the haze and overcast of winter behind, and the days are getting brighter and longer and warmer, and the sun is higher in the sky. It is brighter. You may notice that it's time to start wearing your sunscreen all the time again. You know, in the winter time, I'm really bad about my sunscreen. I'm bundled up all the time, so I don't tend to wear sunscreen in the winter. Unless I'm gonna be outside, then I will put it on my face. But as a rule, I'm not wearing sunscreen in the winter. But as the weather starts to warm up, you're wearing less clothes, you don't have as many layers on, so you absolutely need to start wearing your sunscreen. And now is the time of the year when you can really start to feel that, especially if you're like me and going out to yard sales and stuff now, because the weather's nice and people are starting to have yard sales again. So the other day I was outside and we were yard sailing, and thankfully I keep sunscreen in my car. And I was like, oh shit, it's spring, I need sunscreen on. And I had to run to the car and put some sunscreen on. So you'll just notice that shift to the warmer, brighter, longer days. So let's talk about what the associations for Beltane are. Traditionally, Beltane is a fertility Sabbath. And it is also a fertility Sabbath for me. So everything is fertile right now. The trees are growing their leaves again. The flowers are blooming. All of the animals are coming out of hibernation and mating so that they can have their little babies running around for the summer. I'm already seeing little baby things. We have a lot of geese here in my area. There are fucking geese everywhere. And there's little gooseling babies everywhere. They're so yellow and fluffy and cute. Oh my God. Little gooseling babies are super cute, but those mama gooses will kick your ass. So don't try to take one. Don't try to go pet the baby gooses. So yeah, everything is awake and raring to go. So all of the animals are starting to mate, and you can start to see all the little babies, either pregnant mamas or babies being born, because it is a very fertile time of the year. And along with fertility, for me comes manifestation, because you are growing something, you are birthing something, you are bringing something into the world, and that's exactly what manifestation is. So Beltane is an excellent time to do manifestation magic. So the things that you want to birth, the things that you want to bring into the world, the things that you want to grow, this is the fertile time of year. So this is the time you really want to do your manifestation magic. Or any manifestation work that you do whatsoever, this is really the best time of year to do that. So I'm reading my notes again so I don't forget anything. So what you want to do is use that Beltane energy to help you manifest your desires. You can do spells, you can do vision boards, you can start that new project, share your new thing, take that leap, and know that you're going to be supported, because all of this Beltane energy is just right there for you to incorporate into your manifestation work. So now is the time to start putting those things out into the world and manifesting the things that you actually want in your life. So let's see, some of the things that you can do on Beltane are play music and or drum. I love my drum. I just got it for Christmas, but I absolutely love it. So anything to do with high energy, Beltane is the time of year for that. So find some music that makes you really want to move, grab your drum, play along, grab a rattle, beat on the table, whatever it is, and play some music and or make music of your own, and use that music, raise the energy by playing the music, and use that energy in your manifestation work. We're also going to talk about dancing. That's a whole nother subject, so we'll get to that in a little bit. But another thing that you can do is work with the power of the dandelions. Like I said, the grass is growing like crazy right now, and so dandelions are popping up. And at Ostara, we were first starting to see those first little yellow buds for dandelions. We were starting to see the little heads popping up every so often. Now the dandelions are in full bloom, and you really start to see more of the white, puffy, seedling dandelions. You'll still see the yellow ones, but now you will see a shit ton of the white, puffy dandelions. And those are what you make your wishes on. Oh my God, that breeze is so fucking cold. Holy shit, can you see? I have chill bumps. I don't know if you can see, but fuck, it's cold. My nose is running. It's really too cold for me to be sitting out here right now. God damn it, it's Beltane. I want spring. Anyway, so, dandelions. The little puffy seedling dandelions that you make a wish on. Again, Beltane is all about manifestation, and manifestation comes from your wishes and your hopes and your dreams and the things that you want, right? So what better time than to go around and collect those big puffy dandelions and use them in your manifestation magic? There are so many spells that you can do just using dandelions. It's crazy. You can gather some dandelions, charge those dandelions with the manifestation thing, the things that you want to manifest. There's a big truck going by, so I'm going to pause for just a second. Anyway, gather those dandelions and charge those dandelions with the things that you want to manifest. And then you can make the wish and blow it away and send it out into the universe. You can use that in some sort of a spell working. You can create a spell bottle, a wish bottle. The possibilities with those dandelions are endless. And we're going to talk about dandelions quite a few times throughout the course of this video. So get some dandelions. Take a basket and, oh, there's a butterfly. It's such a pretty little orange butterfly. If I move, it's going to fly away. I can't show you, but just know it's right there. Anyway, get a basket and go out on a nature walk and collect some dandelions. Collect both kinds, the yellow, big yellow headed ones, and then also the puffy white seedling dandelions, and try to keep them in as intact as possible, because you want to be able to use those. You want to be able to use them whole, and you want to be able to use the individual seeds, but you want to be able to take the seeds off when you're ready. So get a basket together and go collect dandelions. And my suggestion is that you collect them with the stem as long as possible. So pluck them from the ground, not from the head. So collect them, because you can always take the stems off that you're not going to use later on. So go out and collect a shit ton of dandelions. With those dandelions, you can also make a flower crown. Flower crowns are traditionally the attire to wear at Beltane. So any kind of flower, you can use wildflowers, you can use dandelions, you can use purchased flowers, but you just want to make one of those little braided crowns and wear it for Beltane. I don't tend to do that because there's bugs crawling in flowers, so there's no flower crown going on this head, but I'm sure that a lot of people would enjoy that. When I make the flower crowns, I actually just use them on my altar. I will make a flower crown, but it is a ring that goes on my altar. So you can also make a flower crown just to use as a decoration for your altar. Speaking of your altar, you can decorate not only your altar, but your entire home or your sacred space, whatever, however you decorate, with fresh flowers, with wildflowers, with greenery, with natural items. Things are so lush at this time of year. You can go around and just collect things. Look, I'm just sitting in one spot and I'm just gonna pick up some of the things around me in my yard. So these are the little seed pod things. I don't know what they are. They fall out of the trees all the time. I think they're seeds of some sort of this tree behind me. And the tree behind me, oh, it's a mirror. Oh, there's one that I can, oh, wait, look. I'm surrounded by them, but this is a crushed up one. I wanted a pretty one. Oh, here's a pretty one. I'm fucking surrounded by them because these trees, these little witch ball, gumball, pain in my ass, fucking ball trees are all over my yard. And I think these are the seeds for these trees. So you want to go around and collect stuff like this. Look, there's little sticks and twigs all around me. Go on a nature walk. If you can't go on a nature walk, like through a little forest or a park or anything like that, just go out in your yard and collect all these little beautiful bits of natural decor and use them on your altar. Use them in your sacred space. Use them in your spell work. These little witch's burrs right here, oh, dude. So many spell possibilities. So many spell possibilities for these things right here. So, go collect some natural items and use those in your decor. Let's see, what's next? Oh, so this is one of my favorite things at Beltane. A really good idea is to make a fairy house. So when Christopher was little, he used to make a fairy house every single year. And he would start it at Beltane, and he would keep adding to it and redecorating it and playing with it throughout the entire summer. So we would go on a nature walk and we would collect all of these items, and he would get sticks and rocks and, you know, big maple leaves and different things like that. And he would build little structures for the fairies. And he would put it in our flower bed and he would go out and play with it and rearrange it and redecorate it and rebuild furniture and just work with the fairy house throughout the entire summer. So making a fairy house at Beltane is super special to me. I think actually I want to make one this year. Now that we're at Dewberry Manor, I want to make a fairy house, like a more permanent fairy house, because it's always nice to make the fairies happy. You know, you want to build that good neighborly relationship with the fairies, because if the fairies are not happy, they will steal your keys, they will cause glitches in things, they can wreak a lot of havoc. So the better your relationship is with them, the less your shit disappears. So I am all about that. You can also leave little treats, you know, little cups of milk, little sugary treats. Fairies like shiny things, so coins or shiny stones, pretty rocks, all that kind of stuff. Fairies love all that kind of thing, all of those kinds of things. So leaving those in the fairy house area is a really good idea too, because when the fairies are happy, you're happy. let's see. Beltane for me is all about doing the things that are fun and lighthearted and playful and make me feel youthful. This time of year, I am so happy. I have so much energy. I am so excited about everything because it's warm, it's sunny. I'm not cooped up and I am shaking off the shackles of the winter blues. You know, not that I mean, I love winter. I absolutely love winter. But by the time spring rolls around, I'm over it and I need some warmth and sunshine. So Beltane is all about that youthful stuff. Go play hopscotch, go on a nature walk, go ride a bike. I've been walking outside. And again, I'm not an outdoorsy kind of girl, but I do need to be outside sometimes. And I love to go walking outside. So I'm getting up in the mornings and I'm going out for an early morning walk before the bugs are bad and before the sun is too hot. And before too many people are out, because I want to have that high energy. I want to get my blood pumping. I want to get moving and be outside. So do the things that make you feel fun and lighthearted and youthful and energetic and playful at Beltane. So we've talked about spending time in nature. If you can, sit on the grass like I am. I'm actually not sitting on the grass. I'm sitting on a little blanket. But the little blanket is just kind of under my butt and I've got the grass all around me, so I can touch the grass if I want to. I can sit here, I can pick up the things around me, I can play with them, I can look at them, I can draw them, I can observe them, I can journal about it, and just spending the time out in nature and being in the element itself. It'll just do so much for you. Trust me when I tell you that. And I am so not an outdoorsy kind of girl. But yeah, it'll do miracles for you. Oh, let's see. Next, let's talk about a maypole. So creating a maypole is a traditional Beltane activity. There are several ways that you can create a maypole. And traditionally, the maypole signify... Oh, well, let me back up a little bit. So Beltane, traditionally... As a whole, signifies the coming together of the goddess and the god, and they are coming together in sex. Sex, holy matrimony, marriage, whatever, however you want to call it. They is getting their groove on. So the goddess and the green man are coming together and they are creating this high energy, and this is their time of fertility. So that is traditionally what Beltane represents. And so the maypole is a physical representation of that. So, sorry, my phone's going off. The maypole is made of a crown, usually a crown of flowers or a braided crown of flowers, or, you know, some sort of ring. It is a ring that signifies the goddess, and then the maypole signifies the man, and so the goddess and the god come together. So this is a maypole. So the maypole goes into the flower crown and they are put together, and then there are usually ribbons that trail down from the flower crown, and the high priestess and high priest, or male and female energies, goddess and god, however you want to look at that, masculine, feminine energies, are woven together to the maypole. So in a traditional maypole dance, the flower crown is at the top, the pole is you know, inserted, and then the ribbons are trailing down. People grab the ribbons and dance around the maypole, and they weave those ribbons together. And as those ribbons are woven together, they come in closer and closer and closer to the maypole, and they are wound around the maypole, and it brings the goddess and the god literally together at the maypole. So creating maypole is a really cool activity. I usually used to make a small one to place on my altar. I used to make one every year and place it on my altar. It's a really good time to do maypole magic. So again, that fertility, that manifestation, that coming together of relationships. Maypole magic can be used for all of those kinds of things. So you can Google how to create a maypole. They're really simple. And you can weave your spell into the creation of your maypole. Oh, let's see. So let's talk about braiding. So along with that maypole idea is braiding in general. So weaving and braiding in general Beltane is a really good time of year to do that. Because of the fertile energy, you can weave things together and create some pretty powerful magic. So with the maypole, with the braided crown, the braided dandelion crown, any kind of braiding that you can do, you can weave your magic into that braid, and this high energy is gonna be woven into that braid as well. So you can create an actual braid of vines, of flower stems, of ribbon, of fabric, of hair, whatever it is that you want to braid, you can weave a spell into that. You can add charms to it as you go along. You can put little symbols in there that signify the things that you want to manifest and the things that you're bringing together, the things that you're weaving together. You want to put little charms, if you can, into the braid of that. You can also create a witch's ladder at this time of year, and I did a video for how to create a witch's ladder a couple of years ago. Actually, no, I think it was last year. There are several different kinds of witch's ladders that you can create, but there is one that is a simple braid that is a witch's ladder with things tucked into it like feathers and stones and things like that. You can also create a moon braid. So a moon braid is a braid that you work with moon energy, so the lunar energy, and it's traditionally a black, gray, and white ribbon that are woven together for to signify the faces of the moon, the dark moon, the full moon, and the intermittent waxing and waning phases. So you can also Google how to create a moon braid, and you can use one of those. You can create one of those on Beltane, and actually the day before Beltane is the full moon, which means Beltane will also have a full moon because the full moon is a 3-day span. So braiding magic and moon magic are going to be especially powerful on this Beltane, and we're in 2018. If you're watching this later, it is May 1st, 2018. So any kind of braiding magic that you can do, Beltane is an excellent time of year for that. My personal colors for Beltane are red, white, and green. Those are also my colors for Yule. But the reason that I use those colors for Beltane, the green obviously signifies the waking up of the earth and the lushness of Beltane and high spring. The white represents the light and the sun and the brightness that comes along with Beltane. And then the red for me is just that fertility and, you know, that mother energy, that that highly fertile moon time energy for the goddess. So those are my colors for Beltane. And I like to make a Beltane braid using those three colors. So now let's talk about this real quick. So back to the manifestation a little bit. I think I talked about this at Ostara. I'm not sure. If not, I'm gonna just briefly cover it right now. Anytime you want to do manifestation magic, bay leaves are an excellent tool for manifestation magic. So Beltane for me is all about fertility and manifestation and high spring, that high energy. So you can write your wishes, the things you want to manifest, your dreams, your hopes, the things that you want to bring into your life. You can write those things on bay leaves, and then you can burn them and send that energy out into the universe. You can then take those ashes and sprinkle them into your Beltane fire. You can place them on your altar. You can save them in a bottle. You can put them in a lake or a river so that they are further put out into the universe. But the energy from that bay leaf manifestation magic is gonna be especially powerful on Beltane. All right, so now let's talk about fire! Because traditionally, Beltane is a fire festival. It is the fire festival. Again, it's not that big of a deal for me. I don't go all out and celebrate Beltane in that way. But I do always have a fire on Beltane. Some years, that's literally a tea light candle. Other years, it has been a bonfire. But any size fire that you can have on Beltane, dude, do it, because Beltane is a fire ritual. It is all about that fire and the lust and the passion and the sexual energy and the fertility and the manifestation, and it all comes together in this huge fire. And by huge, I don't necessarily mean a large fire with big flames, but huge energy contained in that flame, no matter how big your flame is. So, having a fire, for me, is super important on Beltane, even if it's just a single candle, because it really comes down to your intention. And so if you are visualizing with that candle all of the energy of a massive fire still going into that flame, it's still gonna have the same energy. So don't worry about what size your fire is, but try to have an actual fire if you can on Beltane. So for me, there is fire and then there is ritual fire, and I have a ritual fire on Beltane. So I always have fire in all of my magical workings. Whenever I read tarot, I just light candles. I burn candles all the time. So fire is a huge element for me. I am a fire element. So for Beltane, I have a ritual fire. That fire is empowered. That fire is special. That fire has extra intense energy emanating from it and contained within it. So my Beltane fire is a ritual fire, and traditionally the Beltane fire would be a huge bonfire, and then the entire village would come along and they would take part of that Beltane fire to then go home and light their hearth with the flame of the Beltane fire, because it was that important. So you can have your ritual fire in any size. Have it in a cauldron if you can, even if it's just one of those little cast iron cauldrons. Having a ritual fire for me is super important on Beltane. So let's talk a little bit about, let's see. So while we're talking about fire, I'm gonna come back to this one thing in a little bit. So in talking about fire, pretty much any way you can work with fire on Beltane is going to be good. So fire spinning, fire dancing, creating that ritual fire, just having candles lit, any work that you can do with fire is going to be especially potent on Beltane. Dance with a flame if you can, even if it's a little tea light candle, dance with the flame, you know, hold that flame, dance with it. Mimic the flame, mimic the sway of the flame. Try to manipulate the flame. So send your energy into the flame and see if you can make the flame do what you want it to do. And then mirror back and forth. Dance around with the flame, carry it around. If you can, dance around a bonfire. I don't know if you've ever been to a drum circle or if you've ever had the opportunity to dance around a fire, but dude, oh my God, it is so fucking powerful and so empowering and so freeing. And you don't have to think about anything. You just connect with that fire energy and just dance around the fire and dance with the fire. It is so fucking powerful, dude. I'm telling you, even if it's only a tea light candle or a fucking match, do it. You will not be sorry. So, I know I have to say this. I shouldn't have to say this, but I have to say this. When you are working with fire, please be safe. Please be safe when you are working with fire. Think about the clothes that you're wearing. Think about your surroundings. Think about the safety involved here. You do not want to be dancing around a fire in a big flowy skirt. If you are wearing a big flowy skirt, you need to keep yourself away from that flame, because clothes are flammable and you do not want to catch your skirt on fire. I have heard horror stories. I have seen people catch on fire. Not people catch on fire, but I have seen clothes catch on fire because people are just careless when they are dancing around a fire. So keep your fire safe. Keep your fire contained. Keep safety elements with you. Keep a fire extinguisher nearby. Keep a bucket of water or something. Be safe and stay safe when you are working with the fire, when you are dancing with the fire. Jump the fire if you want to, but be aware that is dangerous. I am not promoting unhealthy fire dancing, so be safe in all that you do. Let's see. What else? Let's go back and now talk about this. So traditionally, Beltane is the sex festival. It is all about the sex. It is all about the goddess and the god coming together and doing their thing. And you know. So traditionally, Beltane is a sex festival. For me personally, again, Beltane is not one of my big festivals, but it is all about the sensuality and the sexuality. That does not necessarily mean you have to go out and have sex on Beltane. If you are in a relationship and you want to have sex on Beltane, woo, yes, baby, do it. If you are not in a relationship and you still want to have sex on Beltane and you've got a willing partner, yes, baby, get it. Get you some. Have you some sex on Beltane. If you are single, but you have things that work for you so that you can have your pleasure, yes, do that too. Go out and get you some, or stay in and get you some. But if you are not in a place where you want to have sex, or where you can have sex, or that's just, you are not there, please do not feel like if you're not having sex, you're missing out on something on Beltane, because you're not. Beltane is about sexuality and sensuality, but you do not have to have sex in order to achieve that energy, because you can feel sexy and you can be in touch with your sensuality and not have anybody else be like, this is not for anybody else. This is just for you. So, my nose is starting to run because I'm sitting outside and it is spring and the pollen is out. So sorry if my nose is running. This is about you, okay? So traditionally, Beltane is about having sex and, you know, the goddess and the god coming together. That's not what it's about for me. The sexual and sensual side of Beltane for me is all about me. So I do a lot of self-care, and I do what makes me feel sexy, and I do what makes me feel sensual. So on Beltane, that might mean I am, you know, I got in the shower, I put on some cute clothes, I put on a little dress that makes me feel sexy, or you know, maybe I'm wearing my favorite jeans that make me feel sexy. Might do my hair, might do my makeup, I might go get a pedicure, I might go get a massage. You know, I'm doing the things that make me feel sensual for me, because feeling sensual for me is for me. I'm not feeling sensual for anybody else. I'm not feeling sensual for my husband. I'm feeling sensual for me. So if that means wearing a pretty bra and underwear, or, you know, something that only I know about, then it's for me. It doesn't have to be for anybody else. So getting in touch with your sensuality and your sexuality on Beltane, super cool, does not have to be for anybody else. This is for you. So do the things that make you feel sexy and sensual. And if you end up having sex that day, great. But if you don't, hey, you felt good all day, and that is all that really matters. So I just wanted to say that before I went on. Let's see, what else? Oh, so back to the fire thing. Cleansing with fire is also really good on Beltane. So that whole jumping the fire thing, or moving through fire, super cool to do on Beltane. You can literally light a flame, move your hands through the flame, and you know, you would of course do the whole ritual. You would send all of the negativity or whatever into your hands and then cleanse your hands through the flames, right? Or you could move a flame around you to cleanse, similar to how you would smudge. You could jump over a flame and let it cleanse you. You can move a flame around you. You can move it counterclockwise and remove that negativity. You can use the flame as a cleansing tool, similar to how you would smudge. You would basically cleanse with fire the exact same way that you would smudge. But again, please be safe. Oh my God, you're working with fire, people. Please be safe. I'm not even gonna get into that anymore. Oh, so, and if you can't smudge with a flame, just smudging in general. Smudge. Release the negativity and bring in some positivity. So yes, smudging with fire or with regular smudge. dude, this thing right here, this I will always do at Beltane. I will always burn some shit in effigy. So, because Beltane is such a huge fire festival, burning something in effigy at Beltane can be an incredibly powerful and excellent releasing ritual. Now, am I talking about sacrificing animals? No. Am I talking about burning small children? No. But am I talking about creating a talisman that represents something you want to be released from? Absolutely. If you want to be set free from a toxic relationship, get a picture of that motherfucker and burn it. If you want to be released of negative self-thoughts or negative feelings about yourself, write all that shit down. Dump it. Write it all out. Burn that fucking paper. If you want to be set free from, let's just say, a bad habit, let's just say, alcoholism. You want to be free of the clutches of alcoholism. Burn some alcohol. Be safe, because you know what alcohol does whenever you set it on fire, but burn some alcohol. Now, this does not mean that just burning this shit away is going to completely eliminate it from your life. You still need to take the steps. You need to do the magical workings and the practical real life work. But putting that intention into the burning of something in effigy is so fucking powerful, dude. Burn some shit in effigy. Tell me you don't feel better. Okay? So, yeah, burning things in effigy, really good to do on Beltane. You can also collect the dew or rainwater from Beltane to use in spells or ritual baths throughout the year. You can do divination. So any type of divination, whether that's tarot, oracle, runes, pendulum, scrying, whatever. Do some divination on Beltane, as with pretty much any other holiday divination. Beltane is all about going just a little bit wild, so the wild hunt takes place on Beltane. I don't resonate with that at all, so that is not part of my Beltane celebration, but the wild aspect, going a little bit wild, I try to throw a little bit of that into my Beltane celebration. So that whole burning in effigy, you can get a little wild with that. Let's just say you've been in a really toxic relationship and you want to be free of that motherfucker. Oh yeah, do some spell work, go a little bit wild, write all the shit that you can't stand about them on top of their picture, and you don't want to cause them any harm, but you want this motherfucker out of your life. Burn that shit. Throw those ashes at a crossroads. Dance on them. Stomp on them. Whatever it is. Go a little bit primal. This is Beltane energy. This is not about holding shit in and being gentle. Oh no, this is some fucking fire shit. So you want to burn that shit to the ground. Go a little bit wild on Beltane. Let's see. We've already talked about... And in burning in effigy, I did say we're not sacrificing animals or burning small children, but there is something to be said about ritual sacrifice. And again, I'm not talking about sacrificing living beings, but when you sacrifice something, it means something to you. And when you sacrifice something, it needs to be an actual sacrifice. So let's just say you want to release excess weight. In ritual sacrifice, you could sacrifice food, but you could also sacrifice your favorite pair of jeans that currently fit you at the size that you're at. Now, not everyone can afford to do that. I totally get it. But if it's something that you can afford to do, that is a real sacrifice. Jeans are difficult to find. It's hard to find a good pair of jeans that fit you the way you want them to fit, that make you look good, that make you feel good, that don't give you the little weenus, that don't, that the button doesn't cause a little burn on your stomach, that aren't too long, that aren't too short, that aren't too baggy. Like, finding a good fitting pair of jeans, dude, that's fucking magic. So if you want to release the excess weight, you could do a ritual sacrifice and sacrifice those jeans, because oh my god, that's gonna fucking hurt. Oh, it's gonna hurt. But that is fucking commitment. I'm not saying to go that far, but I just want to get the point across that when you sacrifice something, it should actually be a sacrifice. So just keep that in mind whenever you are thinking about doing a ritual sacrifice. Beltane's a really good time for ritual sacrifice. So let's talk now about some of my personal associations with Beltane and some of the things that we do. Like I said, fairy houses. I used to do a maypole every year. I haven't done one of those in a while. I might do a maypole this year. All about sexuality and sensuality, but for me, it's all for me. I do a ritual feast for every holiday, so I do a Beltane feast. Usually it's, you know, we cook out or have a picnic, something like that. Try to eat outside if we can. Foods associated with Beltane, bread, as always, anything to do with honey or anything to do with bees, really. So general associations for me with Beltane, bees, because the fucking bees are in hot pursuit right now. Honey, obviously. Pollen, obviously. All to do with bees, right? Flowers coming up, still to do with bees. Roses, dandelions, clover, daisies, those little bitty daisies. Penises, yonis. I actually don't call it yoni. I call it coochie, but I was afraid that nobody would know what I said if I said coochie. So coochies and penises. Though you can decorate with them. You can create coochies, yonis, or penises. You can fashion those out of different things. You can make your bread look like a penis. You can make your bread look like a coochie. You can create things out of natural items. So for example, I could literally pick up two sticks and two of these little witch's burrs, and I'm dropping them. So got my two witch's burrs, got my stick. I got me a phallic symbol right there. Create a penis. Done. Okay. So yeah, bees, penises, fresh flowers, especially the springtime flowers, like the wildflowers, dandelions, clover, daisies, those kinds of things. You could make a fertility bread. You could bake a fertility spell into your bread. As it rises, it is being more fertile. As it bakes, it is bringing that into fruition. So fertility bread is really cool. You can also add fresh flowers to your recipes. So I know you can eat dandelion. I know you can eat pretty much any part of the dandelion. Do your own research. I am not an herbologist. I am not a doctor. I am not a nutritionist. Do not take my word for it. Do your own research. But to my best knowledge, you can eat almost every part of the dandelion, even the root. But there are flowers that you can eat. You can eat pansies, you can eat roses. I don't, but you can. there are lots of flowers that you can eat, honeysuckle, that kind of thing. So you can incorporate those fresh flowers into your Beltane recipes. If you don't eat them, you can also use them as just decoration. So let's just say you bake a cake, you could decorate it with fresh pansies because pansies are edible. You could decorate it with fresh dandelions. Back to the dandelion thing, you can also dry the dandelions to use in spells later on. You can dry them to use as decor for your altar or around your home. So whenever you gather those dandelions, keep that in mind. You want to gather some of the big yellow heads, lay them flat and dry them. I have a dehydrator. I put them in my dehydrator. They're dry within just a couple of hours. And then I sprinkle them on my altar. I sprinkle them around my table where I read tarot. You can use them on your food as decor. Make sure you've washed them first, of course. But yeah, you can use the fresh flowers in your recipes as well. So, sweet cakes, salads, cookout foods like hot dogs, hamburgers, ribs, those kinds of things that you cook out. Those are really good Beltane celebration foods. Mead is the thing to make on Beltane. I've always wanted to make mead on Beltane and never have. Maybe this year will be the first year. But making mead, there are a shit ton of tutorials for how to make mead. And like there's even a honey mead that you can make. So making mead on Beltane, I think that would be super cool. I might actually attempt it this year. I don't know. I don't know if I have time. But yeah. Braiding and weaving. So the baskets, you can braid and weave pentacles. You can do the flower crowns, all kinds of different stuff. some sexy shaped foods. I talked about that. Oh, incense. You can also make incense, as always, for pretty much any celebration. Make some incense. So gather some of those wildflowers, gather those dandelions, gather those pansies, gather those daisies, and then incorporate those into your incense as well. So I think that is it for this discussion. I think I've pretty much covered everything. Like I said in the beginning, I'm gonna go back and watch the other attempted video. It took me 2.5 hours to record what has taken me, I don't know, maybe 30 minutes to record today. So I'm gonna go watch that footage, and if there are some really good nuggets, I will slip them in at the end of this video. I make no guarantees. But there may be little nuggets. There may also be just little outtakes from that other video, just because the hilarity that happened in that video was ridiculous. You guys will not believe the shit that went down that day. I can't even tell you. I'll put some of it at the end of this video. Even if there aren't any good nuggets, I'll just put some of the hilarity at the end of that video. Okay, at the end of this video. So that is it for today. I hope you are enjoying this Discovering Your Energetic Wheel of the Year series. Again, these are just my personal associations. I don't talk too much about the traditional side of things. I'll mention it, but I don't celebrate traditionally, and the traditional associations just don't work for me. So that's why this series is just sharing my personal insights and associations to each of the holidays. I really recommend that you do the journal prompts and figure out your own personal associations. You can go do the research if you want. Go read about it. I'm not saying don't go read what other people's associations are and what the traditional meanings are, but anytime you can create your own version of something, it's always going to be more powerful and more significant to you. So do your journal prompts. Figure out what the energy of the season feels like to you, and then go do your research if you like, just to see if there's anything else that resonates with you or anything else that you want to add into your own personal associations and celebrations. So I think that's it for today. I really appreciate you guys hanging out with me. I appreciate you spending your time with me and sharing your energy with me and being here in Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place. You have no idea how much I appreciate you being here and how much I enjoy the interaction that we have here. And I really want more of that interaction. I want more of the conversations to be happening. So I do have some things in the works. I had almost completely backed away from doing anything with my soul's work just because of the way things had transpired. But I'm really feeling the call to do this work. I believe in it so much, and so I'm gonna be working, I am working on things behind the scenes, and I'm gonna be releasing some things in the very near future that really speak from my soul's work, and just things that I think need to be out in the world. So keep an eye out for those as well. If you have any questions about anything, please post them here in Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place. You can also private message me if it's not something that you want to talk about in the group. You can also post pictures of your own celebrations. Share what you're doing. Share what resonated with you. Add things to the conversation. If you do something on Beltane that was not mentioned here, please let me know. I'd love to hear it. So share it in the group. Share pictures. Share what you're doing. And tell us about your celebrations as well. I will link, there's gonna be a file in the group, so you'll go to files, and there will be a file with the video links for all of these videos in the series, and then there will also be a file with the journal prompts. You will do the same journal prompts at every time, at every holiday, because your answers will be different for the same question at every turn of the season. I'm starting to get hoarse because I'm sitting outside, and the pollen is kicking my ass, dudes. All right, so that is it for today. Thank you all so much for being here. I appreciate you so much. Remember, if you like what I do here, don't forget to hit the little subscribe button. That way you don't miss anything. And then click the little bell. That way you get the notifications from YouTube that I have uploaded a video. Make sure you're also getting the notifications from Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place. That way you can see when I've posted something there in the group, because I do post group-only goodies for you all. So if you want to make sure to be notified about that, you want to get the notifications from the group on Facebook. Okay, I gotta go in and get water. The pollen's killing me. Remember, you are fierce, you are fabulous, and you are fucking badass. So keep that shit up, and I'll see you next time. Mwah. Bye!
making all that noise right now.
Great. Wonder how long they're gonna be. Ooh, are they done? Or are they just pausing to give me a false sense of hope? Okay, good. And for me, Beltane represents high spring. Like, this is the midpoint between the first day of spring and the first day of summer. So Beltane kind of falls in that midpoint. And by this time, we should be in high spring. Like, everything should be in full bloom. The trees should be full of bright green leaves. The birds should be nesting and the squirrels are active and wildlife has basically come back in full force. The bees are all over the place. This is the time of year when everything is in full bloom. Everything's covered in fucking pollen. And the flowers are bright and vibrant and, you know, in full bloom. Everything is coming to life at its fullest. So at Ostara was the beginning, the awakening, that first, you know, waking up and stretching after a long winter. Beltane represents, okay, I am fully awake and I am raring to go. Beltane is also all about fire. It is a fire festival because the sun is high in the sky, it's bright, it's sunny. Again, everything is fully alive and awake, and my neighbors are watching me. So I'm trying to, like, I'm gonna pause for just a second because literally two of my neighbors just pulled up and they both just kind of stared at me and then looked at each other and then stared back at me. So I'm gonna wait. Are they seriously taking extra long to get into their doors? My one neighbor is, like, struggling to get into her front door. And the other neighbor's just hanging out by his truck. Oh, and now down the street they're also using a fucking circular saw or something. My neighbor is walking into his garage, but, like, he's walking like this. Still trying to, I guess, watch or listen for what the fuck I'm doing. And we continue. So, as I was saying, Beltane is a fire festival. The sun is high in the sky. There should be bonfires and cookouts and, you know, spending time outside and really enjoying the sun's energy. So along with that fire energy comes a fertility energy. So Beltane is one of the most balanced sabbats or esbats for me. Because I don't tend to do a whole lot of masculine or god-like energy. I do mostly goddess or feminine-centric energies in all of my workings and in my correlations with things. But I do see the sun as a masculine energy, and the sun is one of the only masculine energies that comes into my personal practice. So, along with the fire masculine energy comes the feminine and fertility energy. So Beltane is probably the most balanced of the holidays for me, just because of that aspect alone. So with the sun being high in the sky, everything has come to life. Everything is waking up. They've had a nice long sleep and now they're ready to get down. So it is a fertility season. So this is the time when everything is mating. The birds, the squirrels, you'll see, like, different kinds of bugs flying around stuck together. So, you know, all of the animals, this is their mating time because they want to ensure that they have offspring. Come the summertime, so that the offspring have time to grow and be strong through the fall and winter. So everything is mating right now. Beltane equals fire and sex, pretty much. There you go. And they're still working with the goddamn circular saw. The days have become longer, and as we go into summer, they're going to be getting even longer. Really, with the circular saw? And the neighbors, both neighbors. Both neighbors and a circular saw. Oh, the neighbor husband brought his wife out. This is great. I'm sorry. I know I'm all over the place today. Should I just start again? Should I do this again? Oh my God. So many of my neighbors are out right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of my neighbors. I didn't even know I had this many fucking neighbors. Not only are the days getting longer, they're getting warmer. The sun is higher in the sky. It seems brighter. It seems bigger. It seems to be exuding its power more and more and more as the season goes along. Oh my God, I seriously want to go chop this guy's head off with that fucking saw. And Beltane is a really good time for that because it is that high spring energy. It's that alive and awake and fertile soil, fertile ground, fertile sexual, sensual energy that just kind of manifests life. It literally manifests life. So Beltane is a really good time for manifestation work. And now the fucking garbage man is coming through. Are you kidding me right now? I think I need to start this video over. Jesus. It's a good thing this is free. God, I'm so professional right now. Oh Jesus, now the fucking garbage truck and the circular saw at the same time. Are you kidding me? Oh my God. I can't even. Yes, it can. Oh my God. Oh. Oh. I'm so glad this is a free series. I can't. Can you even hear me right now? I'm just gonna wait. He's gonna stop directly in front of me. And clangity, clangity, clangity. Oh, he's backing up. Because he wasn't right beside the can. He's just sitting there. Not sure what the hell's going on. Oh my God, dude, get your shit together. Stop at the right spot the first time. Oh, he's dragging the shit. Oh my God, this guy. I can't. I don't know what the hell he's doing. I can't. Oh my God, this guy. He needs his license revoked. He really does. If you could only see. Holy shit, he's finally gone around the corner. I've totally lost my train of thought. Anyway, so yeah, fertility, manifestation, Beltane, it all goes together. Start that new project, share your new thing, do your manifestation work. Now's the time to do all of that. So those are my color associations. And now the neighbors are yelling back and forth across the street to have a fucking conversation. I am done. I'm just gonna go on. I've given up. Like, it's just not gonna get quieter. My neighborhood is always so quiet. Not today. I'm just gonna go on. Whatever. I can't sit here waiting for all these people to shut the fuck up anymore. The things that I'm gonna talk about, you could actually incorporate into your ritual, or you could use these things to build your ritual. And that's kind of what I do. I don't go out and specifically like the take the whole day and do all of the things on this list. I kind of just pick and choose what I wanna do that year and build my ritual around it. So, one of my favorite things to do is to play music and or drum. So the weather is great. I've got all the windows open, the doors are open. We're probably gonna have a cookout in my backyard. And so there will be music. There may or may not be drumming, but there will definitely be music and dancing. That's a huge thing for Beltane, is to, just take in that sunny, happy spirit, that energy, that positive flow of energy, and just express it in whatever way comes out for you. And for me, that's listening to music and dancing. It's also a good time to make wishes on dandelions. The dandelions started to pop up in the spring, and they were bright yellow, and now a lot of them are still yellow, but they're starting to turn to the little puffballs that you can make a wish and blow the little seeds away. So it's a really good time to make wishes on dandelions. You can make a flower crown. You can actually, collecting dandelions is one of the things that I tend to do on Beltane. I will collect dandelions, both the yellow heads and the seed heads, and I usually use those in my spell workings or in my altar decorations. I will take the seed heads and use those in manifestation work, and the regular bright yellow dandelion heads I will often dry to keep to use throughout the year for spell workings or altar decorations or offerings as the year goes along. So gathering dandelions and then making a wish on those seed pods. And then also in the gathering of dandelions, I don't eat them. I'm funny like that. You can eat dandelions. You can eat, I think, every part of the dandelion. Don't quote me on that. I'm not a doctor. I'm not an herbologist. I don't fucking know what I'm talking about. So do your own research on that. But as far as I know, seriously? Seriously? Do they really need to fucking yell right now? Anyway, I think you can eat the whole dandelion. So gathering the dandelions, using some of them for your spell work, but also using them as an edible addition to your Beltane feast. You can also use them as decorations around your Beltane feast. You can make a beautiful cake, put the dandelions on it. You can make a dandelion horn. I know there's a really awesome video going around Facebook right now where the lady makes a dandelion horn. So that's another thing that you can do. You can even eat the root of the dandelion. So do your research. Oh my fucking God. And just make sure that you're eating the parts that are edible. Continuing with the dandelions, you can also make a flower crown. So there are plenty of tutorials on YouTube and Pinterest for how to make a flower crown. It's a weaving of the dandelions, and you make a little circlet, and then you can wear the flower crown. You can then place it on your altar. The same with the fresh flowers and greenery and natural items that you collect. You can use those throughout the entire year. Things are falling fresh right now. They're vibrant, they're large, they're lush. And so this is a really great time to collect those things that you'll be able to use throughout the entire year. Milk, honey, those kinds of things. They love sweets. Little sugary treats. There's a fucking bee. Oh my God. Shit. Fucking wasp. God, I hate bees. I hate bugs. Okay. And now the top of my head is getting sunburnt. Oh my God, this is gonna be such a great video. Anyway, yeah, leave an offering for the fairies. They like little sweet treats and shiny, pretty objects. Since Beltane is a fire festival, obviously having a fire of any size is a really good idea. So this can mean a single candle flame, or a huge, massive bonfire. It can be you alone with your little single candle, or a giant group of people, you know, drumming and dancing and singing and celebrating and eating around a huge bonfire. It doesn't really matter how big the fire is, but Beltane is a fire festival. Look at how bright the sun is. Look at how it's shining down on me right now. That is pure fire energy. So the more fire you can bring into your Beltane celebration, the better, in my opinion. So the more you can incorporate that energy into your Beltane celebration, the more it's going to fuel and fire and energize all of the workings that you're doing. So I'm a huge fire fan. So a lot of my workings are fire workings, and Beltane is the perfect time of year to do those fire celebrations and fire rituals and fire spells. So take advantage of that fire energy and incorporate your own actual flame with the energy to just kind of draw it in. Take a candle that you want to use for the year, and I use a red candle. Sit it out in the Beltane sun. Keep an eye on it though, because obviously candles will melt. But at least for a little while, set it out in the height of the day, like around noon. Even if you can leave it out there for an hour at the height of day, like maybe from 11:30 to 12:30, you're getting that peak noontime sun, high in the sky, bright, shining energy right down on that candle. Charge it to use for all of your fire rituals throughout the year. Charge it as your element of fire that you'll use in your ritual. So if you have all four elements in your ritual, this can be your ritual candle. Maybe you don't use it in your spell work, but it's just the red fire energy candle that you light for each of your rituals. So anytime you can incorporate fire of any kind, that's a plus in my book. So another popular May Day craft is, can I help you? Can I help you?
Yes, ma'am. I'm trying to get out of this heat for today, ma'am. Oh, are you doing something?
Yes, I am, and I'm not interested, but thank you.
I'm so sorry.
That's okay. Have a good day. You know, when I sat down today, I said, I'm not going to edit this video. I'm just going to let it flow. This is gonna take me a long time to edit because of all the noise. So another really popular thing to do on Beltane is to build a maypole. Now this can be a very small maypole that sits on your altar, or it can be an entire, you know, 10-foot tall maypole with the ribbons that you take to your large gathering, and everyone dances around the fire and builds the maypole together. You can Google maypoles to learn more about them. It's a traditional dance that is done with the weaving of the ribbons that come down from the maypole. Traditionally, the god and goddess figure, or the high priest, high priestess, the lord and lady, masculine, feminine, however you want to look at it, are the tribe, for lack of a better word, dances around the maypole, and they are weaving the ribbons, and they are bringing the god and goddess together, and then binding them around the maypole. The ribbons are actually intertwined around them, and that symbolizes the coming together of the masculine and feminine. It symbolizes that fertility. There's a ring of flowers that sits up on the top, and it represents, you know, the ring is the feminine, and then the pole going through the ring is the masculine. So there's a lot of that sexual fertility representation and symbolism that is represented in the maypole. So you can, if you're not going to go to a large ritual, you can craft a small maypole to sit on your altar. You can weave the ribbons together. You can craft that into a spell. You can craft that into a manifestation. You can use that in fertility magic. So crafting a maypole and actually working with the ribbons and twisting and braiding and winding them together can be a very powerful manifestation spell, can be an incredibly powerful fertility spell. It can be to represent bringing a significant other into your life. It can be symbolizing a partnership. So there are a lot of ways that you can look at the maypole. Traditionally, yes, it represents sex. Let's just say it. Because everything around Beltane represents sex. So it does traditionally represent that, but it ultimately comes down to what it represents for you and the intention that you put into it. So it can be a coming together, a partnership of sorts. So let's just say you want to work with someone on a specific topic or a specific task, then it could represent the two of you coming together to create together. So don't think of it as it has to be a sex spell. It doesn't have to be traditional fertility, meaning there's going to be a baby as the end result of this spell. Fertility means the birthing of something. So whatever it is that you want to birth, whatever it is that you want to bring to life, whatever it is that you want to bring together and then transform into something else, so you're bringing these two separate parts together to create a new whole, that is the energy of Beltane. And a maypole for spell work is incredibly powerful for that, and it can symbolize pretty much anything. It ultimately comes down to your intent. I talked about fire already, but I want to specifically talk about ritual fire. So the Beltane fire is like the fire of the year. Like, everyone wants to take a little spark of that Beltane fire and take it back home to then build their own fires with. So a ritual fire on Beltane is, it symbolizes so much. It symbolizes, it encompasses everything that we've been talking about already today. So it encompasses that energy, that fertile energy, that powerful energy, that bright energy, that new life, that growth, that manifestation. All of that is encompassed in your Beltane ritual fire. So with leaving the candle out for a little while in the Beltane sun, it is charging it with that Beltane energy that each time you burn, that energy will then be released and magnified and set out into the world once again. So if you want to create a ritual candle, Beltane is a really good time to do that. And creating a ritual fire on Beltane is also an incredibly symbolic thing to do. So you could create a fire, even if it's a small one, in a little tiny cast iron cauldron or in a candle flame, it doesn't really matter how large your fire is. It's the intent that you're putting into it, that it is your ritual fire. And you can then take the remains of that fire and add it to all of your fires that you light for the future, for the rest of the year. So let's just say all you have on hand are tea light candles. And because of your circumstances, you only have the ability to burn a tea light candle. That is your ritual fire. So you take that tea light candle, you charge it in the Beltane energy, and that is your ritual fire. Well, when that candle is then burned out, you would then take some of the wick and break it into your next tea light candle. You could take some of that wax and then add it to your next tea light candle. It's just a continuation. So each time those tea lights burn down, you'll take an element of those and put them into the next one that you burn. And then that goes across the board, no matter how large your fire is. Let's just say you're creating a big ass bonfire. You would then take some of the ash or a little piece of wood that might be left over, some of the kindling, some aspect of that last fire and add it to the next fire, and it will transfer that Beltane energy, that ritual energy, into each fire that you burn throughout the course of the rest of the year. So now let's talk about the sex, shall we? Traditionally, Beltane is a sexually based holiday. Like, it's the sex holiday, and that is the fertile time of year. The god and goddess come together, the masculine and feminine come together, and everybody's having sex. Like, that's what the wild hunt comes down to. Like, he is chasing his prey, and when he captures her, everybody knows what goes down. I do not relate to the wild hunt whatsoever. But that is traditionally what happens at Beltane, the wild hunt, and you know, that coming together of masculine and feminine. While I don't resonate with the wild hunt, I do resonate with that masculine feminine balance and coming together aspect of Beltane. So let's just talk about sex. So sexuality in all forms. That doesn't necessarily mean that you have to go out and have sex. If you are in a relationship, and you want to have sex, then do it. If you are single and you want a one-night thing for Beltane and you want to have sex, oh my fucking God, could it get any louder right now? So we've got two lawnmowers, a garbage truck, and a weed eater. Beltane is connected to sexuality in all of its forms. That does not only mean having sex. That can be you as a sensual woman getting in touch with your sensuality and your sexuality and doing whatever it is that makes you feel sensual or sexual or beautiful, regardless of whether or not you plan to have sex that day or not. That is so not the point. So I think that kind of gets lost a lot of times whenever people are talking about Beltane, because they only talk about the actual act of having sex and the masculine and feminine energies coming together. But I think that a lot more focus should be placed on the individual getting in touch with their sensuality. Oh my God, it is so fucking loud right now. Can you even hear me? Two garbage trucks, two of them right now. And the lawnmowers, two of them, and a weed eater. And it's while I'm talking about sex. I think my neighborhood just wants me to yell and talk about sex right now. Holy shit. Unbelievable. Unfucking believable. I had to keep getting louder. Could you tell? God. So anyway, what I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted yet again was that Beltane is all about sensuality and sexuality, and that should be for the individual to determine and so maybe that does mean you go out and have sex. Maybe you're in a relationship and you want to have sex that day. Hell yeah, rock on with your badass self. Maybe you're single and you just want to have a booty call and have some sex that day. Hell yeah, rock on with your badass self. Maybe that means you don't want anybody else, but you and your playthings spend some quality time alone. Hell yeah, rock on with your badass self. Maybe that means you don't have sex at all in any way, but you are feeling yourself, you are feeling your sensuality, and you are putting that vibe out there for yourself alone. No need for anybody else to recognize it or damn sure not approach you about it, but you are living fully in your sexuality and your sensuality and just feeling good about yourself. And so you're sending that energy out into the universe. Hell yeah, rock on with your badass self. So let's talk about some sensuality. Sorry I am screaming at you right now, but there is so much noise. I want to make sure that you can hear me. I will go through and edit the volume if I need to, but as of right now, I have to scream about sex in my neighborhood. This is great. This is so fucking great. Oh my God. I'm already known as kind of the weirdo in my neighborhood. This is getting so much better. Okay, so sensuality and sexuality in all forms. Yeah, maybe that does mean having sex, but maybe it means you get a massage. Maybe that's a massage from your significant other, or maybe it's a massage that you go out and have professionally done. Maybe that means you have your hair and makeup done that day, either by yourself or professionally. Maybe you wear a nice bright red lipstick, or a skirt that shows off a little bit of leg, or maybe you're wearing a fucking power suit and strutting your stuff. Whatever it is that helps you tap into your sensuality and your sexuality, do that on Beltane. Fuck, do that every day, but especially on Beltane. Oh my God, it is so noisy! Oh, now they've got the leaf blower! Now they've got the leaf blower out! Oh my God. Kidding me right now. My neighborhood is usually silent. It is like the fucking much activity in my neighborhood, and I've been here for like 9 months. I'm getting sunburned, for real. It's taken me an hour and a half to record this video. This should have been a 30-minute video. I've been out here an hour and a half. Oh my God, I'm moving on. I'm sorry I'm yelling at you. I'm sorry I sound angry. I don't mean to. I'm just trying to make sure you can hear me. There's a fucking bees! Shit! So as you can tell, I have had to retreat to the safety of my sunroom. The bees have just, I can't be, and I'm getting sunburnt for real. I don't know if you can tell, I'm getting sunburnt for real. I am still on page one of my notes. I'm so sorry this has taken so long. Now that I am in the safety of the sunroom, hopefully all the noise will shut the fuck up and I can continue in peace. Or not. I'm just gonna ask in the group if you guys want me to redo this whole video because it is so fucking noisy. Oh my God, I'm gonna ask. If you want me to redo it, I'll redo it. Otherwise, if everybody's okay with all the fucking noise, I'm gonna leave it as it is. Now the geese are squawking. Even the geese are pissed off about all the noise. Seriously, there's nothing left to blow. They've blown everything. Everything is well blown. It is so well blown. Can we stop with the leaf blower? Holy shit, he turned it off. Oh my God, okay. I totally lost my train of thought. So, sex, I think that was where we left off. Another thing that is usually connected to Beltane are hand fastings. So many people will either renew their vows or actually get married or perform a hand fasting ceremony on or around Beltane time, because again, it is that signification of the masculine and feminine coming together. Traditionally, a hand fasting is a year and a day. So a couple will come together and commit to a year and a day of living as a married couple to signify their relationship. And then at the end of that year and a day, they can either go their separate ways or decide to take it to the next step and get married. You don't have to stay the whole year and the day, obviously, because it is a hand fasting ceremony, but traditionally, people will give it the year and the day. I mean, unless your relationship really sucks ass, and then bitch, get out when you... then girl, get out when you can. So yeah, hand fastings, renewing of vows, weddings, and another aspect that goes along with those hand fastings is what is known as the jumping of the broom. You can Google that for more information, but it signifies taking that leap, taking that next step. You don't have to do a hand fasting in order to do a jumping of the broom ceremony. You can do one for yourself to signify, you know, leaving behind things that you have let go of in your past and stepping into your future, leaving behind of old relationships and moving into a new relationship, or moving into being a single independent person who is solely looking to take care of themselves for a period of time, signifying jumping into a new phase of your career, or signifying taking the next step in some major aspect of your life. There's still a bee right outside my door. What the fuck is that? That is not a bee. I don't know what the fuck that thing is. Oh, you little bastard. I am so glad I'm in my sunroom. I don't know what that thing is. It's some weird morphed version of a beetle and a bee together. I don't know what that was. Anyway, I'm in the safety of my sunroom. Moving on. Dance. Dance around a fire. Dance inside. Dance outside. Dance by yourself. Dance naked. Dance in a group of people. Go to a drum circle and dance around the fire. Dance around your little tea light. Dance around your tablescape, whatever it is, dance in your kitchen. But turn on some music, something that makes you feel good, something that makes you feel like moving. And whether that means you're jumping around like a kid at a concert or doing a sexy little tease just for yourself, turn on some music and dance, because that energy that is raised when you dance is that same sensual and fertile energy, that powerful energy that Beltane encompasses. So dance. If you are doing spell work, dance to raise energy. If you are creating something or casting a spell, dance and hold the thing that you are creating, or dance and hold your spell ingredients. Dance and hold your ritual candle. Add that energy. Dance, raise the energy, and then press it into whatever it is. You know, ground that energy into whatever it is that you are creating. But raise that energy and then transfer it into something. Charge your talismans. Charge an item that you are connected to. Charge your tarot decks. Dance around your tarot decks. Dance around your altar space. Raise that energy and then push that energy, that vibrant, fiery, fertile Beltane energy, push it into those items. Ringing. Another cool thing to do is to moon bathe or dance beneath the light of the moon. So if you want to take that dance and bring in that sunny, fun, energetic, high flying Beltane energy, do that. But then also bring in that moon energy. That's a more sensual energy. Dance under the light of the moon. You can be naked or clothed. You can be in long flowy skirts or your birthday suit, whatever works better for you. Dance under the light of the moon and take in that sensual energy. When you're dancing under the light of the sun, it's this high, vibrant, you know, almost manic, sunny energy with, you know, drums going and dancing around the fire, and it's a little bit chaotic and a little bit primal and a little bit fucking awesome. A lot fucking awesome. But then when you take it into the light of the moon, it becomes sensual, it becomes personal, it becomes more mystical and more feminine. And you know, you just kind of take it down a little bit, become a little bit slinkier with it. And it doesn't have to be for anybody else. I have to say this, when you are dancing, it is not for anybody but you. It doesn't matter what you look like, doesn't matter what anybody else is doing. It doesn't matter if you know any dance steps. Don't even think about it. Just do what feels right in the moment. And if that just means you step side to side and keep it right here, that is perfectly fine. But if that means that your arms are up in the air and you're shaking it for everything you've got and you're flinging your head and you're very primal with it and there's no holding back and you're just letting it all go, do that. And under the light of the moon, it's the same way. Maybe it is very contained and sensual and sinewy and feminine, but maybe it is that outrageous, just primal letting go and being out in the light of the moon. Don't hold back and don't dance to please anybody else. Do what you feel is right and just allow the dance to come through you and allow the energy to flow through you. Don't even think when you're dancing. Don't even think. Turn the brain off and just feel. Holy shit, I just turned to page 2 of my notes. Oh my God. Okay, we're moving along now. So, let's see. Perform an act of goodwill. So donate clothes. Call your neighbor and say, hey, I know your husband's deployed right now. I made you a casserole. Can I drop it off? Or, hey, I heard you just had surgery last week. Is there anything I can do for you? Stop by, see someone you haven't seen in a long time who you know hasn't been their best lately. Maybe somebody's really struggling. Maybe someone's been ill. Stop by and help them out. Do an act of goodwill. And that could be anything. I'm not even going to give any more examples because that could literally be anything. If you don't have money to give, you may have time or kindness or a hug or a phone call. So an act of goodwill, whatever that may be for you, even if you are at a low point yourself right now, doing an act of kindness for someone else can make you feel better as well. So doing an act of kindness, doing an act of goodwill, because you truly want to, not just because it's Beltane and that's what you're supposed to do, blah, blah, blah. Fuck that. If you don't want to do it, don't do it. But if you genuinely in your heart want to do an act of goodwill, then do that and it will make you feel better as well. And And one of the biggest things on my list, as always, is self-care and self-love. So I take the time on every Sabbath and Esbat to do something good for myself. I become incredibly selfish in certain ways when it comes to the days of my ritual. I have set boundaries where this is my time. Even if it's just 30 minutes or an hour, this is my time. This is my ritual time. This is my ritual space. And that may be my act of self-care for the day. Like setting that boundary and saying, don't talk to me. I'm doing ritual. You know, like I may have been taking care of my family all day long. I may have worked all day. I may have recorded video and edited and done all these things that were things that I needed to get done. But at some point during that day, I'm going to take some time for myself. And maybe that is 30 minutes in the morning to sit and drink a cup of tea and read a few chapters of a good book, or taking the time to perform my ritual, or taking a nice long shower, or taking the time to go outside and dance around a fire. Whatever it is, perform self-care and self-love and stick to it. Don't let it get pushed off to the side just because a whole bunch of other shit comes up. I understand that life happens, but make that time for yourself and stick to it as though it was just as important as some obligation that you have for work, because it is. It is more important. So take time for self-care and self-love. Again, that doesn't mean that you have to go out and burn your favorite piece of clothing, but maybe one of your top five. Or, shit, my camera's gonna die. Okay, so look up Beltane recipes. There are a ton. Anything with honey, dandelions, mead. Making mead is a really good thing to do for Beltane. Make a feast. Anything to do with honey, bees, roses, all of that kind of stuff are really good for Beltane rituals and Beltane feast. I hope I'm still recording. Holy shit, oh my God. So I'm gonna ask in the group if you want me to redo this entire video, or if you're okay with me editing out because of all the sound and me possibly screaming at you for part of the video. But that is it for today. Oh my God, I need water. I hope you enjoyed this series. I will be back again for the next festival. Remember, if you did not watch the Ostara video, you can go back and find that. I will create a file in the group with the list of the videos for each of the Discovering Your Energetic Wheel of the Year series. Thank you all so much for being here and spending your time with me today. Remember, if you like what I do here, don't forget to hit the little subscribe button. That way you don't miss anything. And then click the little bell. That way you get the notifications from YouTube to let you know I've uploaded a video. This series is an Edie's Cosmic Gathering Place exclusive. Please do not share this link outside of the group. It is for you only, because I appreciate you all being here. So this is my gift to you, to share my personal associations with the Wheel of the Year and help you to build your own personal associations. So again, please do not share this link outside of the group. If you know someone who would enjoy this series, please ask them to join the group. That way they can see the videos and participate in the discussion and share what they're doing as well. Thank you all so much for being here. I am going to get a drink and edit this video. Remember, you are fierce, you are fabulous, and you are fucking badass. So keep that shit up, and I'll see you next time. Mwah. Bye!